evaporator. So usually when you come in here, there's a wood pile right about where you guys are standing. So there'd be a hot fire underneath here, which will cook the sap. Sap, if you don't know, from a sugar maple, looks just like water. It only has about 3% sugar in it, and the rest is water. Maple syrup has about 67% sugar. So all we need to do to make maple syrup is figure out a way to take all that extra water out of the sap so that we're left with the sugar. When we cook it in this evaporator, the water comes off as steam. So when this is running and you walk in here, it's so steamy in here that it would be hard for me to see some of the people standing in the back row. That's how steamy it gets in here. So we take that extra water off by boiling the sap. As the water comes off, it leaves the sugar behind, and that's what the maple syrup is. So it automatically changes from sap to maple syrup just by cooking it. So this evaporator is made so that as the sap comes off, the water comes off the steam, the level of the sap in the pan goes down. There's floats over here that go down that allows more sap to trickle in. So if everything's working properly on this evaporator, there's a constant flow of sap coming in. As the density changes, when it turns into syrup, it moves closer to the front of the evaporator. We have a thermometer up here. That's how we can tell when it's finished. Maple syrup boils at 219 degrees Fahrenheit. So when it reaches 219 degrees, we test the density using a tool called a hydrometer. I don't know if you're familiar with what that is. And then when it's finished, we take it off the evaporator right here, and then it's ready to be filtered and bottled. So this is where we spend a lot of time, mid-February to the end of March, making maple syrup. And just another fun fact about sugaring, talking about it, it takes about 40 gallons of sap just to make 1 gallon of maple syrup. So if you buy real pure maple syrup, you might notice that it's pretty expensive compared to like Log Cabin and Aunt Jemima, which isn't pure maple syrup. That's why, it takes a lot of work. And if you look up behind you and above you, there's a bunch of silver buckets. There are 40 silver buckets up there. So we would have to fill all 40 silver buckets with sap from the trees just to end up with one bucket of maple syrup. So we have to keep that 40-to-1 ratio in mind if you're going to try making maple syrup at home. Right? So that's a little bit about our sugaring operation. Shade cloth on and go from there. So in the next few weeks, we hope that both of these will be up and finished by mid-May. If and when we do releases, there's plenty of milkweed here for the monarchs, and it's also other native plants in here as well. As part of the grant for the butterfly project, the field right over here is going to be our native plant garden. So the plan is but This is a little snapping turtle. He's obviously tiny. Check her out. This is Monty. She's a python.